Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. Hi, if you're new here, my name is Katie. Welcome back to another reading vlog. I'm filming this while I get ready. This vlog is actually going to be part two of my previous vlog. It was getting super long, so I decided to split the vlogs up. So if you missed part one, I'll have it linked down below in the description. And if you haven't seen it and you don't want to, that's totally cool too. I'll try and catch you up real quick. Yeah, so today is Sunday. Yesterday I went and got a new bookshelf and I built it and everything. It's right there. Today is gonna be all about reorganizing the shelves and putting them back on and stuff like that. I'm really excited now that I actually have like enough space, hopefully, for all of my books. And I've also made a lot of reading progress. I'm currently in the middle of a ton of different books. The main ones that I'm focusing on right now, I'm reading Brightly Burning by Alexa Dunn. I think I'm like halfway through that one right now. I'm also reading Nevernight by Jay Kristoff. I'm also a little more than halfway done with that one. In the last vlog, I just finished Autobiography by Christina Lauren. And I'm also reading Crashing the A-List by Summer Heacock, and I made some more progress in that last night. So yeah, my plans for today are to get hopefully all of my bookshelves organized and then also make some reading progress. I have some writing to do as well. I'm starting this vlog a little bit late. It's 11:30 because I got up and I just went and walked to my local Starbucks and just had my coffee there and just kind of hung out and then walked back. But that means I'm nice and caffeinated and I got some movement in my day, so I'm all ready to go. I swear to God, putting that bookshelf together yesterday wore me out. That was like my workout for the day. It took me like 2 hours. So yeah, I just wanted to film this short little intro to this vlog to let you know what was going on, and I'm hoping maybe I can actually finish one of the books that I'm reading today because I go back to work tomorrow. It's hard because if I had just been focusing on one book, I definitely would have finished it, but because I'm like reading three at once, I'm like halfway through all of them. So I think if I like pick one to really focus on, I can actually finish it today. Okay, so now it's time to reorganize my shelves back here. I'm pretty happy with the way my new ones are set up right now, but they might change depending on how these ones turn out. I'll explain in a second how I'm planning to organize them. But actually, I wanted to mention that I'm gonna be playing a Skillshare video in the background and just kind of listening to it while I get some stuff done. And Skillshare is kindly sponsoring today's video, so thank you so much to them. I'll have a link down below in the description if you want to try them out. They're offering anyone who clicks the link in my description a free 2-month trial to try out an unlimited selection of all of their different classes. They're an online learning community and I really like taking their writing classes. Similar to just like watching people's writing vlogs and stuff on YouTube, listening to people talk about writing is really helpful to me. I find it really motivating and inspiring. And so since I need to get my writing done later today, I'm gonna be listening to some of the writing classes to just kind of get me in that mindset and get me excited to write later. A class that I'm really liking right now is Writing Authentic Fiction, How to Build a Believable Character. And this is actually taught by Saba Tahir. And if you guys have been staying caught up in my reading vlogs, you know I've been reading her series An Ember in the Ashes right now and really, really enjoying it. So I think it's really cool that they have classes taught by people that I actually admire, especially for their writing. And so taking a class from her has been really, really cool. And that's really motivating too. So yeah, I'm gonna put one of her classes on in the background while we get started on these bookshelves. And make sure to go check out Skillshare down below in my description if you want to try 2 months absolutely free. They have other classes too. Personally, their writing ones are my favorite, but they have ones in design, business, photography, videography. So yeah, let's get straight into organizing my bookshelves. Let me show you them first. So I got started on them a little bit last night. You can see these first like three shelves are sort of coming together, but then the bottom honestly just looks like a disaster. So my plan is, problem is I thought this one shelf was going to solve all of my problems, and now I'm looking at all of the books that I have to go on it and I'm thinking this still might not be enough room, but we're gonna make it work. So this is what the new bookshelf looks like. I've got Harry Potter and my old journals at the bottom, and then I have some paperbacks at the top. And then the middle three are just kind of like favorites shelves. And then also I tried to make it visually appealing with like the color scheme and everything. And so for these four shelves, I'm basically putting the rest of them. These are all red books. I don't have any TBR books on here. And so my plan is to do alphabetical order by author's last name for the hardcovers. And then I'll switch to paperbacks at the bottom. And we'll see how much space I have left over after I do that. And then this little shelf that I have over here by my bed, it only has three little cubes. I think I'm gonna get one of those cloth bucket divider things to put in the top to put all of my wires and stuff in, and then use the bottom two shelves for TBR books. But that's still not gonna be enough space because I have these piles of TBR books and I have these books aren't TBR books actually. All of the books up here I've read. I was as well. So those might end up on the bottom of those shelves. But then I also have, I don't know if you can see this, I have two crates full of TBR books back here. So basically I'm gonna tackle all of my red books first, see how much space I have left, and then we'll go from there.
My books are called The Memory of Pictures of the Tide and Elien of Perception. When I first started writing the book, I had no idea what I was doing, but they were inspired by my work as a journalist.
Okay, so I just finished with all of the hard covers and it gets us to there. I'm gonna pull down the books that are in my closet because I also read those before I get to the paperbacks because I think I might have some hard covers up there too. And we'll see where we get. So these are all the books that were in my closet, and actually looking at them, I think I'm gonna do a sweep to unhaul some because a lot of these I don't wanna keep. A lot of them are old mass market paperbacks from school. And then some books I just didn't like Outlander, I don't really need to keep. Aragon, I don't really want to keep. So yeah, I think the first step is going to be figuring out what books I want to get rid of. I already found one book over there from that shelf that I want to get rid of. So I guess we'll do that. Okay, so these are the books we're gonna get rid of. I'm gonna add them to a pile over there that I already have of books that I'm gonna get rid of. I might list them on my Depop shop, but I honestly might just take them and donate them somewhere. But that means we have all of these books to fit on those shelves. As for how I'm going to organize my paperbacks, I don't think I'm gonna do it alphabetically because I have nonfiction, I have poetry, I have arcs, I have some fiction. So I think I might do it more like by genre and group it kind of that way. And I also found that I got this special edition of Harry Potter while I was at Harry Potter World in London, so we can add this to my Harry Potter shelf. Right there. Okay, so all of my red books fit on here, which I'm really happy about. I might tweak the organization of these last couple shelves later on, but for now, I think they're good. I put poetry in this first cube, nonfiction in the second, and then just alphabetical with the rest of them, and then just kind of threw mass market paperbacks at the bottom. And I still have two left over, which I guess for now I'm gonna start putting TBR books in because I just don't know where else to put them. Ideally, I would love to have a separate TBR shelf, so I think I'm gonna put TBR books on that little shelf over there and in these two cubes. But yeah, they're definitely not all gonna fit, but maybe if I put them like sideways. Okay, so we have the tall books in this one and the normal sized ones in this one. And I threw some of the paperbacks over with the red books just because. So now all we have left are those piles over by the wall. So these two piles are stuff I'm getting rid of for sure. These three were things that I was unsure about. So I guess I'm gonna go through and try and make some more decisions about which books I wanna get rid of. And the leftover ones, I guess, can go back up in my closet. No, I still have that whole shelf next to my bed. Oh my god, I might actually be able to fit all of these on shelves. Oh my god. So I'm gonna add these two to the pile of stuff I'm gonna get rid of. I'm shocked. Like, I can't believe it. I fit them all on a shelf. I don't have to use those crates. I don't have to use my closet. We're obviously a little crammed in here at the bottom too. And I think I'm definitely gonna go through at some point and get rid of a few more books, but as of now, everything fits on a shelf. I'm so happy. It's been years since I've been able to fit all of my books on a shelf. And so I guess I'm gonna go through and list the additional books to my Depop shop. But other than that, I think we have earned a break. So it's about 1:30 now, and I grabbed myself a tofu and veggie bowl, and I'm gonna try and knock out my writing for today. I had a really good day yesterday. I wrote over 2,000 words, so I'm hoping to keep up that streak. So barely any reading has happened since we spoke last. I got really distracted. Not like distracted, I was being productive. I was editing this vlog and yesterday's vlog and like the thumbnail and stuff, but I've only gotten like 500 words written today, and I really want to get at least 1,000 done, and it's already 3 o'clock. So I'm gonna try and sit here and force myself to get that done before I do anything else. And like I was saying at the beginning of this vlog, I want to focus on one book. I'm sorry, these are like really reflective. I want to focus on one book to try and like actually make more progress in it today instead of switching off like I've been doing. So I think the book I'm gonna try to finish today, if not today, then tomorrow, is Brightly Burning, because this is a library book and I need to return it. So this one's a bit of a higher priority. I have listened to a little bit of this today. I have about 6 hours left of it. I've been listening to it on like 1.5 times speed, so that's 4 hours left, right? Math. So I'm gonna try and finish it tonight, but if not, I'll finish it on my commute to work tomorrow. So I just kind of on a whim, I don't really know why, I decided to make some peanut butter cookies and a margarita. I've made some really good progress in my writing. I have over 1,000 words now, and I've been listening to the audiobook of Brightly Burning. I'm on chapter 18, so I'm over 200 pages in. We just got another 100 pages to go, and it's only 5:30. So honestly, I think I can finish this tonight. It really just comes down to if I want to spend my time writing or reading tonight. You know what? Scratch all of that. I'm gonna sit here and drink my margarita and watch Shark Tank. I think I might have a new episode recorded on the TV, actually. That's what we're gonna do. It's Sunday. I'll be productive tomorrow. So good. So I'm just getting ready for bed, and I've been reading Brightly Burning. I mean, I think I'm in like chapter 20 now. I have like 4 hours left of the audiobook. So I don't think I'm gonna finish it tonight, but I am gonna read it until I go to bed, or maybe switch off between this and my usual nighttime book, Crashing the A-List. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you enjoyed my bookshelf reorganization. That was actually really fun for me. I haven't done one of those in a really long time. If you missed part one of this vlog, I'll have it linked down below in the description. But yeah, if you're new here, I would love it if you would subscribe. I put up at least 2 new videos every single week. All my social media is linked down below in the description. If you like this video, I'd appreciate it if you would give it a thumbs up, all of that good stuff. And other than that, I think I'll just see you guys in my next video very, very soon. Bye. So hit me. So hit me. So hit me. First a confession. With you, I feel a connection. With